Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and trace this pattern piece with my polygon internal line. I've already taken time to make sure it's the right scale. So because of that, I don't really need all these guides. So I could probably delete them, or I can just go up to display environment and just uncheck show guideline. Okay, so to trace this guy, okie dokie. So this is hard because I do have a pleat, but I have a little bit of experience with patterns where I can see the grain line at the top, and I really know it just goes straight up. Like, I really would bank that all this little extra space is what's folded in here. So I might just eyeball a little bit part of it. But for the rest of it, I will trace with the polygon tool. So the polygon tool is the solid line. It's right underneath the fabric tool. And keyboard shortcut's G. I'm going to click it. Okay, so I'm going to start with the underarm right here. Pretty easy. I can just click to do a straight line. Click again for another straight line. I might just hold shift and I'm going to hold shift and just say my grain lines right here. And I'm just going to go ahead and click right here. I know there's a little bit off. I'll just deal with that during a fitting. And then now I want to do a curved bell shape. So I'm going to hold command. I'm on the Mac. So I'm holding the button that's closest to the space bar. I think that will work on the PC. But by doing that, it's letting me do a curve. Okay, I don't really like that shape. I'm going to have to clean it later. And I'm going to do another one down here. And then I'll do a double click to finish. Click, click. Okay, cool. And I am done. Oh, maybe I only had to click one time. I don't know. Okay, anyways, I'll just say delete. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and use the Z tool and just kind of click on. Oh, look at that. They're not connected. That's interesting. That's okay. I'm going to maybe play with this curve, the edit curvature, because there's no real. Is there a point there? Let me double check. Let's try the edit curve point before. Yes, there is a curve, a point. So why don't I just, should I bring it down? Okay. No, I'm going to bring it back up. Okay, I'm going to bring it back up. It's this part I want to bring down, so I think what I have to do is use edit curvature. So I'm going to hold that and just kind of drag just this part a little bit down. Maybe I can even bring this point up a hair. Over here. I'm not sure if that's good or bad. Okay, I think it's good enough for right now. Again, we're gonna do a fitting. We can clean up stuff later. Okay, cool. So I traced it. Now I'm gonna have to go get my backside and trace the back and then merge the pattern pieces together for the sleeve, because usually the sleeve is not cut on a fold. Usually your bell shape is a different shape in the front than it is in the back. Okay, but for now I'm going to go ahead and make this a pattern piece, and I can merge it, you know, after I draw the back side. And to make it a pattern piece, because right now it's an internal line, it's not a pattern piece. I know that because it's yellow. We need it like blue, like our square fabric. So I have to make it a pattern piece. So to do that, we're going to get the trace tool. Okay, and this might not work unless my internal lines intersect with my pattern. I'll just try it and show you because we're learning. So, oh, it's actually all selected, so I don't even have to select it. I'm gonna right click, traces pattern. That's exactly what I want. Boom, click. Oh, it worked, fine. Okay, good, ignore that thing. If you're ever having trouble where it's not working, what I would recommend doing is, because maybe there's like an open line somewhere for some reason, and if there's like an open part of the pattern, it just doesn't know how to fill it, I guess. I don't know. So you just right click and you say, it's not even here. You say like extend. It's not here because I don't have that problem, but you guys might have some pattern pieces that have some holes in it, and you would right click and you say extend to like pattern edge. And it looks like a weird shape, but you still trace it, and it'll copy your pattern piece and ignores the extended line. I don't know. I'm sad that didn't happen to me because I think that's a good learning thing. Okay, so there we go. So there's that guy. And I mean, I don't really need this graphic anymore, so I guess I could just delete it. And go ahead and import the next one and keep doing that until you have all your pattern pieces. One more thing though, before you finish, to stay organized, please label your pattern pieces. So I'm gonna select this guy. I'm gonna open up my property editor, and right now the name, it defaulted to whatever number that is. I'm gonna change this to like front, oops, why did I add the letter Z? There we go, front sleeve half, I don't know. Well, it's not really, whatever. Once I merge the front and back sleeves together, I'll probably rename the pattern piece to just sleeve. But for right now, I'm just gonna put a note. This is the front one, so I can stay organized. Okay, let's see here. And yeah, I think that's just about it. Okay, as always, if you guys have any questions, let me know.